dear friends, distinguished guests. Beirut catastrophic explosion on August the 4th have been new tragic events for an entire country, Lebanon, as other countries have been devastated for the unique reason that the criminal Iranian leadership is still in power. Regional and global terrorism continue to be Mullah's fundamental strategy. It has been spreading even further now that the theocratic regime feels weak and endangered. Terrorism and repression are financed, directed, and implemented by Iran's bloody hands. Hezbollah, IRGC, MOIS, and an enormous intelligence apparatus. Today's Iran is a huge threat for the entire world. How many nations and how many families have been devastated by Iran actions, by the number one terrorist state in the world? How many thousands of murderous attacks the Islamic Republic and their proxies have launched against Americans, Europeans, Arabs, Asians, Latin American citizens all over the world? 20th century genocides in Europe, Africa, Asia began and developed always mainly because of cowardice, dreams of appeasement, fears, and lack of political will on the side of governments and public opinions. The same governments and public opinions did have all the means to prevent, in those occasions, to prevent such obscenities. They did nothing. And in the best of cases, they did too little, too late. We all know what did happen in Iran in that summer of 1988, following a decree issued by Ayatollah Khomeini. Political prisoners were executed en masse in a matter of a few months. The international community in its entirety did know at that time and still knows very well nowadays. The United Nations, the UN Security Council, the General Assembly, the UN Human Rights Council, they all are knowing and did know for many years. There is no doubt that 1988 killings were crimes against humanity, the clear beginning of a vast political and ethnic genocide that it is still the real work in progress for the Iranian theocracy, a work in progress against all opposition groups, religious and national minorities, which are dissenting from the regime. Many of the perpetrators of the Iranian regime's perpetrators currently still hold key positions. For example, the head of the then of the Iranian judiciary, Ebrahim Raisi, and the Minister of Justice, Ali Reza Awaei, have been members of the death commissions. Mustafa Pour Mohammadi was also a member of the death commission and now is a close advisor to the so-called moderate president, Hassan Rouhani. Many personalities and organizations, like the Organization in Search of Justice, individual governments, have appealed to the United Nations in order to establish an international independent commission of inquiry. They have called to the United Nations to conduct independent investigations, to provide accountability and justice for the victims of these horrendous violations of human rights. The Iranian genocidal regime must be stopped and must be brought to justice. His long arm, Hezbollah, must be included in its entirety in the list of terrorist entities sanctioned by the European Union, the United Nations, and other regional or global organizations. And the same should happen for the IRGC and MOIS. The imminent session of the United Nations General Assembly is the first and most urgent opportunity for our agenda aimed and the establishment and promotion of the rule of law and justice in Iran. Freedom and democracy, dear friends, will be very soon a reality there in your country. It will be very soon a reality because a widely popular political and moral force has further grown and strengthened even during the present crisis. And it has done so under the strong and impressive leader of the Iranian resistance, the leadership of Madame Maryam Rajavi. Thank you very much.